Having variables and values in our program doesn't really help us if we can't modify those values in some ways. We need to be able to perform math operations like addition and multiplication. We want to change our variables using tools other than just assignment. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how you can use Java operators in your programs. There's only two goals for this lesson. One, know what operators are, and two, know how to use them. This should be a fairly simple lesson. We'll cover all the operators. For the most part, operators are just the symbols you're used to using in arithmetic. There's a few exceptions, and we'll cover that. We're splitting this into two lessons. The first video will cover what are operators. We'll also talk about assignment, arithmetic, and unary operators. The next lesson, we'll finish with the rest of the Java operators. So, what are operators? Operators are special symbols that perform operations on one, two, or three values or variables. For example, this is the plus operator. It takes two values, the one and the two, and returns the result of addition. So the result of the operation makes this statement count equal 3. The equal sign is also an operator. This takes whatever variables on the left and assigns it to the value on the right. We've seen plus and assignment operators many times already in this course, but there's many other operations you can use. Here's the complete list of operation categories you can use in Java. These operators all return a single result. Let's look at arithmetic, assignment, and unary operators first. The assignment operator is probably looking pretty familiar by now. The important takeaway here is the assignment is one single equal sign. The value returned is the variable set to whatever is on the right-hand side. The right-hand side can be literals, variables, or even other operations. The rule is whatever type you've defined for your variable on the left must also be the same type as what is on the right. If it's a number primitive, you must be able to do a widening conversion. Otherwise, you must cast the right value to the left value. We saw a bit of casting in the variables lesson. So let's go look at code real quick to make this assignment clear. So we can define a variable called a and set a equal to 1. That's the simplest assignment. The variable of the type on the left gets set to the value on the right. If it's a reference type, you're getting the reference assigned, not the value. Operations can be chained. They have different rules on direction, but for the most part, it's what you'd expect. Equality is always left gets the value on the right, and it has to make sense too. You can't set equal to 2 and then equal to 3. You can set A equals to B equals to 3. Coding like this, it's really discouraged though, and you really should assign each variable in their own Java statement. So I'm just showing you it can be done, and this is how it works. So working from the left in this case, 3 gets set to B, then A gets set to B. The last thing to note is the equals operator makes the expression a Java statement. Arithmetic operators are the ones you're most familiar with. We'll call them the math operators. The first four should be very familiar to you. These are your basic operators: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. The last one is called modulus. When you do division with integers, you can have a remainder. So 5 goes into 6 one time with a remainder of 1. 5 would go into 5 one time with a remainder of 0. Let's go back to the code and check this out. We'll use the assignment operator with these. The reason is math operators aren't enough to make Java statements. You can make a value with math operators, but Java doesn't know what to do with it until you assign it to something. So again, we use a and set it equal to 1 plus 2. So a equals 3. Let's control the order of operations again. Let's do 4 div 2 plus 3. When we run this, we get 5. So the operations are moving from left to right. We do 4 div 2 and get 2. Then we add 3, and that's equal to 5. Let's put parentheses around the 2 plus 3. That means we'll calculate 2 plus 3, then divide 4 by the result. We should get the answer 0.8. We run it, and we get 0. That isn't what we expected. What happened here? So here's a hint. Look at the type of A. It's an integer. Everything here is an integer. So the div is an integer division. 5 goes into 4 0 times with a remainder of 4. The remainder is lost. So types do matter. Let's switch div to modulus and run it again. We get 3 and 4. In the first case, we have 4 mod 2, which is 0, and no remainder. Then we add 3, and we get 3. In the second case, we add 2 and 3 to get 5. 5 goes into 4 0 times with a remainder of 4. So that's how modulus works. One other thing to note is when the modulus of the number equals 0, that means the number is a factor of the other number. So here, since the modulus is 0, 5, 10, 15, and 20, and so on, are factors of 5. That's an important thing to remember. It's been a popular interview question of late, and we're going to use this again when we cover loops. The unary operators perform operations on a single value and return a single value. The first one is just sign. This makes the value or variable positive or negative. You'll definitely want to use parentheses with these. Otherwise, it can get tricky knowing if you meant addition and subtraction or changing the sign. The other four unary operators are prefix and postfix addition and subtraction. So if we need to add 1 to a variable, we can just use plus plus. The plus plus is the same as saying I plus 1 and assigning it to I. Minus minus does subtraction. You'll often see these used as part of a more complex Java statement. So why do we repeat the symbols on different sides of the value? Well, let's play with each one of these and see what happens. Let's set I equal to 1. Then let's set j equal to 4 plus 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 I. On the next line, we'll do it again, but do j equals 4 plus I plus plus. Now, what do you think the value difference will be here? Well, in the first case, we get 6. What's happening is we're getting I, adding 1 to it, and then returning 2. 2 plus 4 equals 6. In the next case, here we get I, add it to 4 to get 5, and then add 1 to I. In both cases, I ends up equal to 2. The unary operator determines if I gets incremented before or after it's used in the arithmetic. If it's on the left, it's before. If it's on the right, it's after. Let's do the minus minus operator for completeness. I'm going to change the pluses to minuses like this. Now what do you think we're going to get? Well, we get 4 and 5. So in the first one, we took I equal to 1, subtracted it, which left 0, and then added 0 to 4, leaving 4. The second one, we took I as 1, added to 4, giving 5, then subtracting 1 from I, leaving 0. So in both cases, I ends up equal to 0. Okay, hopefully that made sense. If not, I encourage you to play with the operators in code on your own. You should also try the exercises. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments or on dgu.com. Hey, thanks for watching the video. There's a quick quiz for this on dgu.com if you'd like to gauge how much you learned. If you like the videos you're seeing, please let me know by liking the video and hitting the subscribe button for the DGU channel on YouTube. I'd really appreciate that. If you have concerns or questions, please leave them in the comments below or on DGU.com. There's a poll on the front page of DGU.com, so you can also let me know what topic gets covered next. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.